I was just asking, since you mentioned earlier you've done many Valentine shows with him, what was your memorable performances with him?
Oh, so many. It's countless, actually. I mean, he performed everywhere under all circumstances. You know, big concerts, small concerts, even awake. Four in the morning concert. So many memorable experiences, but we miss him because we have developed a team effort of three. So now that he's here, the dynamic sort of changes. But it's a dynamic that's new, that is also fun, workable. Kaya rin kami magkasama, so we now have to fill the gaps.
My second question is, ano po yung, ano siguro po yung look forward po ng fans nyo on this All Heart concert?
On this show?
Yes.
This show? Well, as I said kanina, Valentine's show has to be on point. Valentine's show, love. So, we've written so many songs. We chose the best love songs here.
Yes.
To sing it here. And in the way that it is arranged, it is already different from what you how you know it. So that would be what I feel and what I would call and what we aim for is to surprise and delight our audience.
Thank you,
but
congrats. Looking forward to see your concert.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is Leah. Yeah. Hi, good afternoon.
Yes.
How do you expect to sing as a duet now that you will perform on stage again after a long time? But you haven't performed as a trio before, di ba?
Yeah.
For a long time, but you performed as a duo without Danny. Even
yes.
When he got sick, you stopped performing. But so have you gotten used to it?
Well, the thankful element, and we're very grateful to say this, is that kahit nagdalawa kami, kahit naman isa man ako pag kumakanta ako sa Sydney, the moment mag-start the song, it's a sing-along already because people know our stuff.
Oh, yeah, because they know the songs.
Yeah, it's the song that carries us now. We used to carry, when you have a new recording, you carry the song, right? Kasi kilala ka, oh, ako song ito. Pero pag popular na yung song, kahit na isang apo, dalawang apo, tatlong apo ng YouTube, may life of its own na yung song. And that, we are thankful, marami kaming gano'n. So, that's why we're still around.
Can we hear from Mugla?
Oh. It was difficult to start with talaga. Kasi parang nag-uusap pa kami ni Jim. Oh, who's gonna do the lead voice of Danny? Ang hirap. Wala talagang kaparis yung boses ni Danny. So, effort kami ngayon, effort. And we're thankful, sabi ni Jim, we're thankful that we're still healthy enough that we can still project our voice na lumabas naman ang tunog-apo pa rin, tunog-apo. And at the same time, in our shows now, we always have backup singers to help us. Kasi sabi namin, tatlong boses parati yun eh. Hindi natin magagawa yung magalawa lang tayo. So, we have a backup of voices and we've got friends already who've been regularly been helping us in our small shows that we do. In fact, this will be the first big show that we're going to have a backup singers. So, para marinig, kasi sabi namin, unfair naman, hindi lumabas yung tunog ng apo. Yung tunog ng apo kasi is talaga the harmony. And we've worked on that and the two voices will always be there, but we always need a third. So, to cover up for that, we have two other singers with us who back us up also. So, we'd like to guarantee that we're trying to get the whole Apo sound even better.
Although, may I add?
Yes.
Although, Bubu and I have done recordings na kami lang dalawa.
Really?
Yes, you can actually find it on YouTube. No? You just go to my channel.
Even before Danny passed?
Yeah. Yes. Because you know, he was too sick to even record, actually. Mm-hmm. And when we recorded, for example, the song Quarantine Baby, I was in Cebu, Bukuri was in Manila. So through the wonders of technology, yes. You know, pasa-pasa na, no? We were able to do it. No. Now, the surprise was, when it came out, people said, tulog ako.
Okay, that's nice. Anyway, have you, who's your MD for this one? And have you lined up the repertoire?
Yes, we have. The MD is Elmer Lacaflor, yes. We still have to meet sa rehearsals. Pero as far as ako is concerned, we've already submitted our stuff.
Actually, we will just have to, kasi I'm sure the band is not our band.
Yes.
It's Elmer's band. So they're already rehearsing it now para, you know, sa mag-fit in na lang kami.
So how did you wind down the songs? How did you trim down the songs? There are so many love songs.
Well, sabi nga ni Jim kanina, we just chose the...
The best one?
The what do you call it? The gooey. The sweetest yung pinakabalagkit. Malagkit na kanta.
Saka ano, sa dami nga, hindi kami makagawa ng ano. Kasi, three spot numbers. One is a long medley. Without even touching the big ones,
the favorites.
Yeah. This is a long medley of hits. Tapos,
so opening yun? Long medley agad?
No, iba pa yung opening.
Ah, okay. Open.
Yeah.
Thanks. I am curious to find out if your backup singers are also male. Or backup singers, male or female?
Male and female.
Ah, male. And how did you audition them?
We asked around our friends. I don't know, matagal na ako sa industriya. Sabi na, so yung mga sanay na. Kailangan sanay na talaga. Madaling makasama.
We have backups of backups. Pati yung backup sa inyo namin may backup yun.
Pag-i-available. May add things, Lea.
A
tribute of sorts for Nani
within the show?
No, not in this show. Not in the Kaya Trino
show?
Maybe. Maybe that you have to catch.
Pero parang, you know, not a big, not a tribute really, because it's a different topic.
Yes, yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Natalie, me and the question
to ask a question. Thank you. Mr. James, I'm Natalie from the Philippines. So, sir, tanong ko kasi you produce so many love songs na mention natin na personal favorites niyo, can you name at least three? Tapos, konting kwento lang po, or one or three na, anong, paano siya nabuo? How, the story behind the song?
Okay. For example, when I met you, when I wrote that song, there was a flow the moment I wrote it. Then I was, you gave me a reason, and it all began when I met you. Stop. Di na ako nag-continue. 7 months later, when I played it, pumasok yung refrain. He taught me how to laugh. Doon ko lang natapos. Pero ganun din. You can't dictate inspiration. You just have to catch it.
So yun yung favorite love song mo, sir?
Hindi, ang favorite eh. Pero I'll talk about the song that I wrote, yung paano. Yung paano. Kasi marami nga nagtatanong, ano bang kwento ng paano na yun? Bakit parang ayaw ng babae? Pinag-uusapan mo ayaw ng babae. Eh sabi na, di ba? May asawa ka naman, nagpapagawin yan. Paano mo naisip yung kantang galon? May nakilala kasi ako babae.
Ito na.
May nakilala akong babae na nasaksan talaga. No? Tapos nag-iwalay siya sa naman niya. Tapos parang yung sobrang galit na galit siya sa kalalakihan. Na ayaw na raw niya umibig ulit. So naisip mo, nasakit siguro nung kawawa naman, di ba? So iniisip mo, kung ako lumigaw sa isang gano'n, ang hirap, di ba? Yung hurt na hurt yung babae, kailangan mong talaga na tawag. So, boss, sorry, hindi mo girlfriend na. Iba, kapag-abahay ka lang pag-usapan natin. Anyway, so yun ang kwento nun, na subukan mong magmahal ulit. Kaya yun ang person, subukan mong magmahal ulit. Talagang nakakaiba naman talaga. Ang hirap mag-convince ng babae na sakta na talaga ng gano'n.
For the third one, I want to mention Uyunan ng Damin na romance. I think heartbreak songs are very interesting. In this case, it's like a love has diminished. At wala na, hindi mo na madaya, as they say. Mapili ka madaya. I actually wrote that because a friend of mine gave me a phone call.
Friend?
Hindi ka. A friend of mine called me and told me that his wife had left him. And then, you know, the question siya, sabi niya, I can't fake it anymore. Not take it. I can't fake it anymore. There's nothing left. So, tinagalo ko lang yun. Kahit na anong to, hindi mo na mapihihit at madaya. Meaning, sa sarili mo, nawala ka na mabubura. So, I thought, well, every group should have a great heartbreak song. That's why I wrote that.
Sir, last question ko lang bago mag-others. Siguro, kasi talaga yung your song, Mr. Foodies Day. Alam mo yun, yung not just classic, but there's still well-loved. Tapos yung even before Heads pa mga kayo, parang raming gusto na kayo-kayo mo reunion concert or stuff like that. So, maybe I really just want to know how do you explain the Apple Magic? Why is it still, alam mo yun, yung parang, why until now, your songs are...
I'll attempt to answer it for you. For me, once I saw an ad on TV, it said, in this world, you either set the pace or you chase it. When you chase a trend, when the trend is at an end, you're at an end. But in our case, parang, we just wrote without following anything except what we felt. It was really just, kumbaga organic yung feeling. No? And pag-organic, it's real yan. Huh? So, mas kakapit sa tao kasi hindi ka nagpapastylize, you're not being pretentious or anything like that. So, I think that's one element. The other one is, we didn't try to be whatever artist of the Philippines, in some sikat na no. We wanted to write in songs of the love lives of Filipinos, of ordinary Filipino life. And I think that got on because it's real and it's true. Kumbaga, yung mga ibang artists, naghahanap sila, kumbaga traveler ka, tinatanong anong direksyon, yun yung mundo. Sundan mo lang yung mundo. In our case, without our planning it, kami yung naging mundo. So, meron nangyari. So, ito na lang kami.
Last na lang, sir. Kung may kanta kayo na gusto nyo revive or bigyan ng bagong interpretation or re-record, reimagine. Meron po ba? You were to release a new
actually, marami eh. Kasi marami kami, actually, sa totoo lang, marami kaming songs na hindi naging hit. So, nag-uusap na kami ni Jim ngayon, iniisip namin na one show in the future, gagawin namin yung mga never heard songs namin. Yung mga songs namin na baka namintis nyo lang, baka this time pagkarinig nyo, ay, oo nga, no, bakit hindi nag-hit yan? Yan ang gusto namin na itarong sa mga manonood namin. No, sabi nga ni Jim, ang tawag doon yung mga misses. Hindi yung mga misses, ha? Yung mga misses. Yung mga hindi nag-hit.
The one that got away.
Yes, yung mga ganun. So, actually, we're thinking of something like that. And to part na, to me, really, personally, there's one song that Danny did, wrote, and we recorded it, but we never really actually sang it. I don't think we even sang it. And it's a very jazzy number, and it tells everything about the person of Danny. And that song is Care. And the song is I Just Need Care. That's the song. So, well, you can research it, but in time, I'm sure Jim and I will find a way to bring up these old songs that you missed. And we probably missed giving it to you. We gave it back to you again.
Ano, let me just say that, you know, like for example, Tingin ng Damdami was written what? Oh, maybe about 87 or something like that. Nung nasa Australia ako during the, ano, the pandemic, I looked at the song again and I felt it was, I felt differently about the song already as the songwriter. So I actually re-recorded it. Na wala nang bigit sa free time. Parang nagsinatra ako. No? And the emotion was already different. I'm more mature now. All of that. So, yeah, you can rethink songs. And I think there's no rule against rearranging something with it.
Thank you.
Question
that's easy. Was the song Anna written for any particular person?
That was written by Louis Ocampo,
yes,
for a girl that he liked.
Oh, okay.
And then he asked us to sing it.
Alam mo si Louis, lahat ng love songs niya, kami pinapakanta niya. Yung Ewan, gusto niya rin lumilo sa ibang babae, kaya pa kami kumanta noon. Yung susunod naman yung Anna, kami rin pinakanta niya. So tanongin niyo si Louis, alam niya. Oh, kasi alam ko, tinanong mo yung Anna, kaya gawa na yung album namin. Tingnan na ito si Louis kumawa, nagpadala ng kaset pa at that time. Sabi niya, pare, pwede niyo makantay, isali niyo sa album ito. Sabi ko, bakit naman? Sabi niya, kasi kayo naman pwede kumanta nito. Hindi naman pinakinggan namin. Sabi namin, ang ganda nga ng kanta, Tunog Apo. Pagkawa niya, Tunog Apo na talaga. Sabi namin, Louis, bakit ba? Sige na, kasi... Crush ko yan eh. so sabi namin... Yeah, sabi namin, sige. Pagbigyan na natin ito si Louis, Louis.
This is not known to everyone. Nung tatlo pa kami, we always gave an honor to people that worked for us and helped shape our sound. And we called them the fourth Apo. Louis was one of the fourth Apo. So was Lori Illustre. So these are people who sort of gave us direction also. I mean, we knew what we wanted, but they sort of expanded the horizon. So Louis would be such, because he gifted us with Ewan and Anna.
Thank you. Nice to know that.
So at that point, ladies and gentlemen, if you have any more questions, I'm sorry, pero naman. MJ,
would you like?
Yes.
I am Jay.
Yes,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, right.
Kumusta po? Yes, pasensya na. Galing po kung ano, no? Kabiasnan, Mandaluyo. Oo, nasabayan ko po kasi yung rush hour. Pero anyway, ako po si FJ sa PD5. Yung tanong ko lang po kasi nag-show na kayo noong December sa 19 East. Tomorrow you will have it in theater, you know. How have you adjusted po so far sa mga shows ninyo? What have you noticed, di ba, na performing na kayong dalawa lang, and the crowd, yung crowd po na pinapanood
ko. Well, the crowd was saying, to me, Buboy, not so much, because he expected it. Ako, nung 19 East, you know, at my worst moment, I mean, I knew we had fans, but at my worst moment, I imagine, sabi ko, we're not in the radar, we're not being played, we're not on TV, the young people are listening to different stuff. So, when I went there, sabi ko, putin lang small crowd ito, if we don't do well, it's, you know, it's okay. Right? But my gosh, the reception was so amazing. You know, every song was a sing-along, actually. And we only had we got a three-piece band now. Para mag-iba lang yung sound. Maglaro tayo, diba? So the bass player had to play certain notes that another instrument would play, you know? And the piano player had to adjust and all the time to different sound. And it worked. And you know, sabi ko, well, napaka-negative ko naman na. I even imagine that it wouldn't work. So after that, we said, let's do a... We wanted actually a repeat of an intimate experience like that. So we chose Teatrino.
So just want to know kung ano po yung mood nyo or what was it like going to that show? Were you nervous or what was the mood?
Ito na ang tawaan yan. Yung 90s, actually, that was planned way before. And then, Danny got seriously sick and then he passed. So naka-plano na yung 90s. Gagawin na lang. So sabi na, yung 90s, baka ano yan, tribute to Danny? At sabi na, no. We've prepared this gig talaga a long time ago. And sabi na, eh, paano yun ngayon? Kasi yun namin yung fans. Sabi namin, well, of course, we'll miss it. But sabi namin, no, this is too small a show to be a tribute for Danny. So, people are expecting sometime that we're going to have something that will have a little tribute for our loved one. So sabi namin, maybe sometime this year, we'll probably come up with something like that. But, Not now, not in this little show. Kasi when he passed na, yeah, there were a lot of interviews that we had to cancel. We didn't want to talk about it. Parang, una-una, ako, even if I'm in showbiz, I'm in movies, I'm in television, ayaw kong gamitin yung pagkapatay na isang kaibigan mo para mag-promote ng something. Kaya nga sabi ko, iwasan ko na ako, tahimik na lang muna tayo. So that's why, sabi ko, masaya kami na natuloy na may 90s. Maliit na show, maliit na programa, pero yung mga dumayo, parang kapamilya namin lahat.
Saka ano eh, for us, the death of Danny was not a surprise. For the people out there, it was a shock because they had no idea he was sick. So I mean, years na to eh. Years na talaga nung masakit si Danny. Just getting worse and worse. So, let me have plan. Let's do this. Even the campaign people were expecting us, that Danny gonna show up. Impossible. I mean, you can make him wait in the dressing room the way he was, you know? And then stand up and sit there like, you know, I'm okay and everything. Hindi talaga pwede. So we were just sort of just avoiding it. But we were, of course, you know, even if you expect it, masakit rin. And we were kind of like, kind of very depressed. But I remember when we were thinking of a title, we knew Danny had a sense of humor, so crazy titles were coming up like that. Apo minus one. Okay, go. Danny will appreciate this, but not our audience, you know, they're still mourning, so.
And I believe, for example, like said, Sir Danny was sick for quite some time. And even then, the two of you have already been doing shows and recording songs.
The concert was in Singapore.
Pero paano po yung decision niya? Was that hard or parang do we go on without Danny or... Was that...
Yeah, that was a decision that we made. Kasi, I don't know if you remember, we actually retired in 2010, officially. And I think we didn't do anything for like 2-3 years. No? So, eventually, the invitations came in. I said, hey, can you just do this small show lang for the school, for our school? I mean, kasi, Ateneo naman, di ba? So, we thought, we did something. When we do that, people react, alam mo, pwede pa eh, pwede nyo namang gawin eh, maski kasama yung si Noel Cabamon, pwede eh. Sabi lang, yeah, you know, pwede nga, gano'n. Tapos, we let time pass again. After a few years, somebody invites us again. Can you just sing in a wedding, can you do this? So, gano'n nag-umpisa yun. So, eventually, sabi namin, ano ba, parang, kinakati tayo. Parang, diba? Parang nakikiliti na tayo. baka gusto mong na, sige, sabi ko, okay. Eh, mas si Jim, di ba? Eh, madalas, uwi-uwi rin siya pabalik-balik ng Australia. Tapos ako, I was busy with television and, oh, so parang, okay lang. Pero nung, sabay kami nagtingin ng ganyan, parang, oh, ano?
Game.
Game. So, ganun. That's how it happened.
So, ano talaga, even after retirement, yung kumbaga, age to perform,
you know why?
Never really
went away. Let me say this. Ako was born out of fun and friendship. It was never about the money. I mean, thank you for earning a lot of money. You went through bad times and good times, but that decision was the end when we don't feel like it anymore. And at the time we ended, Danny didn't feel like it anymore. So we said, okay, that's the agreement anyway. But ako, like for example, should I stop writing songs? No. So I continued later. In the last four albums na ako namin. Tapos, subukoy nga, no? Hindi tayo dito sa wedding, so let's go. Parang it-evolve na lang ito, ay na lang. And we don't use Apple Icon Society anymore. We use Jim and Buboy or Buboy and Jim off the Apple Icon Society. Parang may difference in it.
Just one memory, sir. Pinaka-favorite niyo when you were starting out, if only to remind yourself. I don't know,
when you
were
starting.
Favorite, or
pinaka
hindi pa namin
never
remember.
Memory
from when you started.
Too many, but right now, since we're in front of Ateneo, it was where we met Danny in the counselor's room. Now, he was a new student. We were from Ateneo High School. And Basil was there. Basil was also hung around there. And we would just sing spontaneously, you know. That was a great memory, and then it was initially Danny was attracted to Basil. No, kasi pareho yung choice of songs na gusto niya, di ba? Tapos biglang nag-gravitate si Danny towards us.
Kasi hindi natin alam, mas matanda pala si Danny sa atin.
Like 4 years, oh.
Ahead talaga si Danny sa amin. Kaya lang, ang nakakuha naman kay Danny talaga. Nung nag-umpisa kami, nag-gitara naman eh. Nung humawak siya ng gitara, sobra palang mas magaling pa siya mag-gitara sa atin. Alam mo si Danny, tumutugtog pa ng banjo. So, alam mo sabi na, sino to? Magaling to, ano? So, yun. Naging barkada na namin at nakasama namin. Yun ang mga early days
namin. At he was able to arrange a party between our class and the girls in international school. So, he became very popular. In fact, we can girlfriend ko yung isa doon. Anyway, so, Ateneo, we would sing in Danon. Yung song namin sa Nangako Barkada, that was it. Nagsimula ang lahat sa square na bakas. Nagsama-sama ang labing dalawa because people joined and left. And people, even Rick Segreto was part of it. Which people don't know, yeah. He was one of that crazy Guamanian, di ba? Who enrolled at the Ateneo stage for 2 years, but he was part of us.
Thank you very much for joining us here in the conference. We hope people out there, the guys who showed up all heart, this is a Valentine's presentation, and it's not just us, so many other people with love songs will celebrate you that night. This is all a heart tribute to all the lovers out there. It's our first Valentine after the COVID season, di ba? Kaya mga kaibigan, pwede na magmahalan. Pwede na mong umupo magkatabi. Pwede na rin mag... Paghalikan! Pwede na mag-yakapan. Diba? O, mag-holding hands. Suot mo na yung maskara, suot ka ng guantes. Pwede rin. Basta naka-antigen ka, okay.
To all those who are taking out girls, they wanna be on a date this Valentine, and you haven't closed the deal yet, this is a deal maker. Galing mo rin may love na sa'yo.